What's going on, everyone? So it is looking like the Chicago Bulls are going to head in the direction of a rebuild. And they're going to make out, right? Got Zach Lavine, which several teams are very interested in. You're probably going to have a form of a bidding war because he has a longer-term contract. So he's just starting out his 2 of 5 years, $250 million contract. It's a lot of salary to take on. But teams will be interested, right? You already hear the Sixers potentially looking to bring on Zach Lavine, the Knicks, and I'm sure that there are other teams that would be more than happy to bring in the 28-year-old. He's dynamic, can score in all three levels. When he's on, he is up there as far as like just that vacuum score and can really make an impact on many rosters and contenders amongst the league. Right, it's just kind of coming up with the assets as well as the salaries to match, whether it's a one-on-one deal or it's a multi-team deal. Maybe it is one of those things where you just see several teams kind of pick pieces off of Chicago and various other teams to kind of make the deal work. Eventually, Zach Lavine, I expect to go. To me, he's the first domino, right? Like, yes, the Bulls, they could trade Demar, and they probably should trade Demar regardless, just because he's a free agent after this year. And it's like, would you really run the risk of losing him for nothing, right? Like, even if for whatever reason they do decide, like, hey, you know what, let's keep Lavine right out the year, you still got to trade Demar Derozan. I don't know what they would yield for Demar, because I do believe that there are several teams that would love to bring in Demar Derozan. The issue is he is a free agent, right? So how many teams are willing to, one, take the chance and take the risk on him, and two, like, where would he prefer to go, right? Where, like, Zach Lavine, like, we already learned from the Damian Lillard trade, right? If, you know, he says, I want to go play for the Knicks and only the Knicks, trade me to the Knicks, but, you know, Sixers are like, we don't care. Like, what are you going to do? Are you just going to not play, right? We saw what Milwaukee did with Damian Lillard. Right? I'm going to Miami. I only want Miami. His agent supposedly was running around telling teams don't trade for him. He's only going to play for Miami. And guess what happened? He's sitting on the Milwaukee Bucks, right? But DeMar, on the other hand, if he says, hey, I want to go to the Lakers. I only want to play for the Lakers. The only team I'm going to re-sign for are the Lakers. Guess what? Nobody but the Lakers are probably trading for him because no team is going to want to run the risk of giving up a bunch of salary pieces and he leaves. Right. And now he goes and signs with the Lakers, and him being 34 years old, right? Like, I just think teams would back off, but you'd still get a good return, right? Because the Lakers are going to have to give up something to get DeMar DeRozan. And therefore, you're going to get probably a Rui Hachimura, a D'Angelo Russell, maybe a first round pick, or, you know, a pick in a swap or something. And then you're going to be able to just unload Zach Lavine and get your haul from. And then you have other guys like Alex Caruso. And, you know, Vu and other pieces like Colby White and things like that, that teams may be interested in. So Chicago's going to make out like a bandit. But what I think is funny is that Chicago has, again, they have Vu, they have DeMar, and they have Zach Lavine. But none of those guys are probably the hottest on the Bulls for trade partners for the rest of the league, right? So what's funny is, you see all the reports that Alex Caruso is on the trade or on the trade block would lead to a line of 10 plus teams. So basically, if they do decide, hey, we're going to start doing this teardown here, we're going to start this rebuild, they trade Zach Lavine, then if Alex Caruso also becomes available, then there's going to be a line out the door for Alex Caruso. And I just think it's funny that Alex Caruso will probably be more in demand than anybody else. Right? Because one, his salary is so reasonable, every team in the league could trade for him. Like, literally, every team in the league could trade for him. Where, again, a DeMar DeRozan, how many teams look at him as like he's the missing piece? And with him being a free agent, how many teams want to take the risk? Zach Lavine, as great as he is, he's making $40 million this year. So how many teams can trade and give up $40 million in salary without just completely just tearing down their team and go and acquire Zach Lavine, right? But Alex Caruso, who's making under $10 million, right? It's like, oh man, like we could easily trade for him. And he just brings so much value to pretty much every team, right? This is the ultimate, or one of the ultimate, just plug and play guys, right? Because his energy, his hustle, just his ability to just be a point of attack guy, his ability to just defend and lock down. Offensively, he's been brilliant this year. I don't know how sustainable it'll be for one, and two, it is a smaller sample size, right? But like, you look at Alex Caruso, he is averaging 8.6 points, which I know doesn't sound like a lot. 4 rebounds, 2.5 assists on 60.8% from the field, which is absolutely insane. And you look at his stats this season, he's been lights out. He's shooting, as I mentioned, 60.8% on 5.1 attempts per game. Again, small sample size. But you look at his three-point percentage, he's on 3 attempts, 2.9 to be exact. He's shooting 44.8%. He's shooting almost 45% from 3 and 81.8% from 2-point range. Again, on 2.2 attempts per game. But again, he's more of the defender, the point of attack guy. You could start him, you could bring him off the bench. He's got a good high IQ. He's not going to do anything that's above his means, right? He's going to play into the role that you ask him to play. Like, he is one of the ultimate glue guys. And every contender in the league could use Alex Caruso. All of them, right? And I think it's very likely that there will be a bit of a bidding war. Now, Chicago last season made him available, quote unquote, but like, the asking price was just an unrealistic. It was one of those things of like, you know, I don't want to sell this, so I'll just put out an insane price, and if somebody gives it to me, then they give it to me, and I'll sell it, right? You know, it's like you have a car or a collectible or something, and you're like, it's only, you know, a collectible, it's worth like $100, but I don't really want to sell it. But if somebody offers me 5, why not? Like, right, I could go get another one at that point, right? So you saw them like trying to get like 2 first-round picks, or they were willing to settle for like a quality young player and a first round pick. It was ridiculous. Alex Caruso will probably yield a first in the right situation from the right team. It's not going to be some like lottery first or anything like that. But you know, you get a team like, I'm trying to think of a contending team that still has still has salary. But like, let's say like the Warriors, right? The Warriors could go and trade for the guy, especially because they love guards. And you know, you're not going to get, like, that's not going to be a top 5 pick, right? They're probably not going to get something like that, but you might be able to get some nice quality piece as well as just some, you know, mid to late round first, which is fine, right? Because at that point, again, you're just trying to accumulate assets. You're just trying to hopefully hit on a couple draft picks, and now you're in a position for the rebuild, right? But Alex Caruso, I mean, there's not a contender or just fringe playoff team in the league that wouldn't like Alex Caruso. And there are probably teams that are kind of on the cusp that may even be interested in him, right? Some of these teams that may want to kind of make a push and might be looking at it as like, okay, they're not going to be able to trade for a Demar or a Zach Lavine, but maybe we could get a guy in like an Alex Caruso who could come in and kind of impact this roster, right? Like a team like the Pacers, who are right now the 4 seed. Do they maybe make a move on him? The Knicks, you know, a team like the Nets, right? The Cavs could probably use him. In the Western Conference, you know, like Sacramento or like the Pelicans, they could probably use him. You know, Houston has really loved these just vet guys. And they're the 4 seed in the West right now. I don't know how long that lasts, but they are. You know, even like the Mavericks, right? Mavericks could use him like really bad, right? I mean, Mavs are 9-3. They look good. But I mean, to have Caruso alongside Kyrie and Luka, I think would be really good too. Just to kind of give you that defender. But again, he's a guy that is going to be in heavy demand. Because of his skill set, he plays above his contract. His contract is extremely reasonable also. So all those things bode well in the scheme of like, hey, we could use a guy like this. He's an NBA champion, right? He won a championship with the Lakers. So he's a guy that's been there, done that, and was a huge part and piece to that, right? He wasn't just some like into the bench guy that didn't contribute and didn't do anything. No, he had a huge role. Question is though, too, is that again, he's making $9.4 million this year. Next year is partially guaranteed. You still want to find a team that is that he's interested in playing in, right? Because you don't want to trade for him. I mean, unless you do end up winning a championship or something, right? And he's kind of like that help guy. He's like a big rotation guy. But in all reality, right? So he has, like I said, $9.4 million this year. Next year, it jumps up to $9.8 million, and it's only partially guaranteed. Not that I don't see any team trying to waive him or anything like that. But after that, he'd be an unrestricted free agent. So you basically would have him by the time Chicago is willing to sell the farm, you're only going to have him for like a year and a half, right? So again, would you like Zach Lavine? You still have him for 3 years, right? But Caruso, he's not like Demar where he's a free agent, but you know, like if you know, like, hey, if we're going to trade for this guy, he's just going to leave in a year and a half. Does that maybe deter a couple teams? I mean, if you're a team that truly believes Caruso is a piece that moves the needle, then probably not, right? Because sometimes you just got to roll the dice. Sometimes you just got to take the gamble. But look, I think it's funny that, you know, he's going to be that guy that really just makes a significant impact for some team somewhere. And on top of that, he's going to probably have the biggest market for all the other pieces, or all the other players, right? And Demar and Lavine. I just find that pretty funny. But anyway, but as always, this is a discussion, so I pass a question on you. Let me know your thoughts and opinions down in the comments below. How do you feel about this? Do you think, like, yeah, I mean, it makes sense that he'd have such a big market. Where do you want to see Caruso land? You know, obviously the Lakers are heavily linked to him, but there's several teams I could use him. Miami, I mentioned a couple already. Warriors, Suns could even use him. I don't think they'd have a way to get him, but you never know. Again, however you feel, whatever your thoughts are, love to hear it. Let me know down in the comments below. That being said, if you haven't liked this video, hit that like button. Helps me out a lot. Lets me enjoy these types of videos, and I truly appreciate it. If you're not subscribed to the channel, hit that subscribe button. Turn on the bell notifications. I appreciate you all. See you in the next one. Thank you.